Hi, guys. Bye, guys. But anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. So right now, like I said in the last part, we'll be revisiting Spiral Mountain for the time being, because we have two things we can do here. First and foremost, and okay, Bottles, just ignore me. I'm on duty. Don't worry, I'm working. Help, it's me, Royston. I was knocked off the barbecue and ended up under this rather weighty boulder. Please get rid of it. I can hardly breathe. So it goes from being under a barbecue to being under a rock, or on a barbecue, being under a rock, okay. Being under a barbecue would still be uncomfortable. Ah, that's so much better. Shouldn't you be in the water where it's safer? You're right. I'll probably dry up and die if I don't get back to the moat around Spiral Mountain soon. I suppose you'll be wanting a carry then. Well, I'd walk there myself, but we goldfish are a little disadvantaged in the leg department. Ah, good one, fish. So we just go snugly right into our back sack. And we just have to jump into the water. So yeah, this fish has had it rough. He was on a grill in the last game, I believe, in the end game. He was in a fishbowl. Now he's under this rock, but we finally saved him. Thanks, guys. Perhaps these extra bubbles may be of some use. Bubbles? We want at least a G for that. Sorry, I'm all out of those. However, I'll also teach you how to swim faster. Simply press X and A together. Cheerio! Oh, I forgot this game was British. I gotta love Rare. Gotta love them. But now we can swim much faster by hitting X and A at the same time, and we have more bubbles. Awesome! So that's definitely very, very highly recommended doing, is saving that fish, because it helps out in the air and the swim department. And if you were doing that jiggy in Glitter Gulch Mine, the water cavern one that I was tackling, that I knew about, that swimming section would be much easier, so... Yeah, if you want to actually come back here before doing that, then I would recommend it. So heading back into Grunty's old lair, we're going to talk to Cheeto because we have enough pages to get a cheat. Great, you have got enough pages for me to tell you a new secret cheat. About time, spill the beans. Hand over my precious pages first. Well, here's one page, we'll keep the rest of the six. Much obliged. My first cheat is feathers, got it? Wow, hard one to memorize. Here's a small clue as to how you reactivate the cheat. Mayhem Temple, Code Chamber, letters, got it? No, I still don't understand. I do, Banjo, come on, let's go use that cheat. Did I really just say rememberize before? I just wanted to point that out and just say, tell you I'm not crazy and whatnot, but that's not a word, it's memorize, rememberize, what the hell, man? Sometimes I just create words, it's just so weird, I don't know. I have like a dyslexia kind of thing where I always say words backwards, but that's like a new one, I'm creating words now. I'm evolving, oh god. Alright, so anyway, we're gonna go over here and show off someone we can actually reach now that we have the grip grab move. And it sucks because I did this in my practice file, I didn't know it would save it. I'm just super bummed that I couldn't show it off, and oh man, it just stinks. I don't know, the saving system in the Xbox Live version is just, it's a godsend and a curse, so I don't know. I'd rather take the lesser of two evils in the saving, but... Hey, what are you gonna do, right? But anyway, if the cartridge was still here, you'd pretty much be walking around. You can beak bust it by doing that, or you can put it on fire, which I find a little more amusing. That's the cruel side of me talking, but either or, you get an egg out of it, and we can actually, I can show it off right now. In the Xbox Live version, you get, they actually call them names. Like, at Stop and Swap, you play the Xbox Live Banjo-Kazooie version, which I'll be getting all the things, don't worry, later on. But yes, this is called Stop and Swap 2. Better than a slap, and the winner is. That's what the eggs are called in this game. Obviously, one of those was, I think, the winner is, or the slap one. But yeah, in the N64 version, they're actually just eggs on their own, and you actually have to give them to Heggy, and she'll actually do things with them. But Heggy only hatches eggs, I believe, from the first game, so. Just so you know, in playing on the Xbox version, but. For now, we're actually done with Spiral Mountain. We did what we wanted to do here. I don't think we're coming back here for a while, unless we get three more Cheeto pages. Because, yeah, the Cheeto pages are actually worth collecting because they actually boost up your individual things, like feathers, like we just got. We'll boost our feathers from 100 to 200. So that's definitely going to be very useful, especially later on towards the end of the game. And why did I just miss that? No, I don't want to do that. Kazooie. Okay, there we go. And let's just get these guys, and yeah, I'm just showing off where the second Stop and Swap item is now that we know the Grip Grab move, because basically when you learn the Grip Grab move, you can get the first two pretty easy that were intended to get, you were intended to get. And I believe in here was supposed to be the Ice Key from the N64 version, but in this game, they actually changed it back to a cartridge, and it gave us that thing I showed off before, so just so you know, the two locations and whatnot. So we're done with that. You don't have to worry about bringing them to Heggy, like I said. I just wanted to show off one more thing in Jinjo Village. That's actually over here. It is on the red Jinjo house. I believe there was a... Yep, there's a big note thing right there. Yep, we want to do that. Because now we have the grip grab move. We can do a lot of things. That and the build drill unlock a lot of new areas we can tackle. I think if I'm not mistaken. There we go. And okay, this is a little harder than I thought. Let me try this again. Go in the window. Okay, now I'm just screwing around. Come on, we don't have a lot of time here. We're on a deadline, Banjo. Let's see. I don't know why I can't do this. Let me try this again. Okay, was that simple? Are you kidding me? All right. Enough pouting aside, there we go. We got the note thingy. Got 20 notes out of that. I'm happy, you're happy. We're all a little happy. And there's actually something we can get down here. I'm not actually sure. I know there's an area that we didn't explore down in the Jinjo Village. And I might as well take this part to show it off, because this part's more of like a catching up kind of thing, going back to other worlds and whatnot. So just want to cover all my bases, and that's kind of weird that they drilled through there and put it sealed off, so we can't do anything in there. This, I believe, takes us to Wooded Hollow, I think? I'm not sure, don't quote me on that, but maybe it is a little shortcut, so might as well go in anyway. Oh, no, it just takes us to a random area. It's in Wooded Hollow, okay. Not a random area. So that's a nice little shortcut, but I don't know why you just wouldn't use the silos, but whatever, some people are like that, I guess. Do a no-silo run of Banjo-Tooie, that would be awesome to watch. And very boring at the same time, pretty much the same walkthrough, I don't know. Nothing would change, but yes, we are back in Mayhem Temple, we're actually going to do a few things here. Go to the prison compound, rescue that little mole creature, and get that Jiggy in, I think it's Glitter Gulch Mine, yeah, that counts toward that Jiggy. And there we go, let's speak file on it, and, big drill out, I keep calling different things. And eek, thanks very much for unblocking my passage. It's worth a Jiggy, hand it over, you plague-ridden pest. Eek, you'll have to come and see my Master Bill about that. I'll have to see Mr. Bill. Oh no! Okay, he said Master Bill. Master. Aw, man, what the hell? Where's the mole? Where's that mole? I just saw it go right past me. My rodent partner, Dilbert, is still missing. Funny you should say that. We had another look around and managed to find her. There she is now. Yay, we rescued her. Hi, honey, I'm home. Dilberta, is that really you? I'm so happy you found my Dilberta. Take this pretty little gold nugget as a reward. So he gives us two Jiggies, basically, if you come right down to it, he gives us 20% of our Jiggies in Glitter Gulch Mine. We helped him out with dynamite, and we helped him out by getting this Jiggy by saving his little friend. I don't know, like, do they have a friend relationship, or is it like a marriage kind of thing? I don't know, I don't want to question it in this game, but we'll just move on. I don't want to question it. Let's see, now we want to go to, Mwamba's, because I actually did this off-screen. I actually forgot to knock out the entrance, to the cheat area with the, Golden Goliath, but I did that off-screen just to save you guys some time, because it really would be nothing special to show off. You just kick this thing. Nothing special. This is the area where I got that Jiggy that was way too high to reach, but here we go, the code chamber, just like Cheeto said. This is where you activate my cheat. Stand on this podium if you want to know how. Oh god. Just kill these guys. They make me feel a little uneasy. Oh god, exclamation point one. We don't want to get that. So let's stand on the podium, and you must spell out the cheat code I have given you. Use the left stick to move the aiming sight and press LT and RT to fire. Aim carefully, though. If you hit the wrong letter, you'll have to start again. If you already know all the cheats, I don't think you can cheat and go ahead and put them in. I think you have to have the game actually activated for you. So don't think you're going to be cheating right here. I love how it says arse backwards up there. It's pretty funny, and just want to be very precise. It's pretty finicky aiming with the egg sight, because it always, like, if you let go, it goes back to the center, so I don't really like that, but what are you gonna do? And S. So ours is highlighted, there we go. The feather's chi will double the maximum number of red and gold feathers that you can carry. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, the gold ones double as well, so we have 20 gold feathers now. But in order to activate the cheat, you have to go to this little scroll thing and hit A, and there we go, it's activated. So we'll be seeing, wait, did it activate? I don't think it did. Oh, it did activate, okay. For some reason, it didn't show it off. Oh well, so we have 200 red feathers and 20 gold feathers. Awesome. So I definitely recommend doing the cheat, like I said before, and let's see, where are we gonna go right here? We're gonna go back to Wumba? Well, actually, wait, we wanna go back to Dilberta's place. Okay, that's, last time I forgot about doing my practice file, but you know what, I actually remembered it now, so. Yeah, it's just one of those jiggies you end up just putting off to the back burner, because we didn't know a certain move to get to it, so that's probably why I forgot about it. Probably wanna go back to Prison Compound, and instead of going left this time, with the waiting moves, we actually want to go and hang a right, because we know that move. There we go. That actually worked out in my favor that time. So let's just grab onto this ledge, kill these little, I don't even know what those creatures are. They just seem so out of place in this world. Like, they're just blue little snappy things. Like, at least the ones in Clanker's Cavern look Banjo-Kazooie-esque, but this one's just, like, just there. I don't know. Looks a little too monstery, I guess you could say, for this game. So there we go, and there's the Jiggy right there, but now we know how to remove this boulder out of the way, so we can actually go and get it. That's a big-ass boulder. Like, compared to the other ones, that's a substantial boulder. Okay, enough talking about boulder size. All we want to do is, which one's the witch? Which one is the witch? Not Grunty, and there we go, that's the witch. The witch of the pillars. Yeah, that makes sense. Witch of the West, Witch of the Pillars, same thing, right? We want to go this way, I believe. Nope, it's the other way, okay. And we have basically a timer. If you run out of time, it'll reset, so we want to do this as quickly as possible. But it's kind of a pain in the ass. You hit the pillar, it shows a cutscene, it saves. Do you really need to save? Like, the auto-save thing is just a little too crazy sometimes. Okay, oh, yep, it saved, there we go. I was gonna say, it didn't save that time, but no, it did. It did. I did like a little backflip over that tiger guy. That was pretty cool. A little acrobatic. And there we go. We're done here. And let's just go claim our prize. And once we get this Jiggy, we will be done with Mayhem Temple once and for all. We'll be never coming back here. Ah, that's such a shame. No, it's not. Bye-bye, Mayhem Temple. See you never. This place wasn't so bad. I mean, in Glitter Clutch Mine, I gave it a lot of crap in this last couple parts. Especially when I was in Mayhem Temple. It wasn't that bad. I thought it was much worse than I remembered. But I could think of worse worlds in this game and more pain-in-the-ass worlds in this game that would give me much harder trouble than that. But either way, I had a strategy guide that helped a lot too. But yeah, anyway, we're done with this. So let's leave Mayhem Temple and we're done collecting everything. So now that we're done collecting everything, I think I'll show off just opening the next world and then we'll call it a part. So that was a nice little catch-up part. We have a lot of jiggies right now. We have 21 jiggies. We only need 8 to open up the next world. We can pretty much open the next world or 2. Or maybe even 3. I don't even know, man. But I like to do them one by one, just not get confusing and whatnot. Not to go too ahead of myself. But yeah, the pieces are really easy. I mean, a child can do this. And as I say it, I mess up. But yeah, it's not me missing. It's just more of the controls being a pain in the ass. Yeah, way to blame the game. Hate the player, hate the game. I guess I am doing the expression. And there we go. And there we go. So there we go. I think there's like a bouncy castle that's showing in the picture. That's pretty cool. And a horseshoe, too. This world looks exciting. So challenge 3. So you now have a great one. We'll show you the way. So that was challenge number 3. I believe there's like 9 or 10 challenges. And each challenge represents the world. So that was the third world, third challenge. Makes sense, right? So let's feel the vibrations in my controller. Let's just do good vibrations, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch. Oh, that's a great song. It's actually my birth song. Behold the power of the mighty Jiggy Wiggy. I think that was like the number one song when I was born, so that's like pretty much my birth song. I think that's how it goes. And we're in Pine Grove. We haven't seen this area yet, but yeah, we'll be going to this area to go into Witchy World. And by the power of magic, the gates open. Like, we couldn't really open that gate by ourselves. Like, there's no crowbars in this world. We couldn't just jump the fence. Come on, Banjo. Be a little childish and, just enter your inner child and just hop the fence, man. That's what we used to do back in the day in the schoolyard. Okay, I never did that, by the way. But I imagine some children did. Whatever situation need be. And so let's just go back to the plateau area. And I'll be opening up the gate to get to that area. Because in order to get to Pine Grove, I think it was called. Angel Grove, Pine Grove, whatever. You just want to have your fire eggs. You're going to need those. And not get hit. Very rude. Oh god, it's going right at me! No! Okay, good. Just lit him on fire. Oh man, I'm sorry, buddy. You were just coming right at me. That was self-defense right there. self-defense. And let's actually go through this area right now, and I'll fill my health bar, and now it's at full. Banjo, because we are so happy. I don't think I have enough empty honeycombs to get an extra life thing. I think I needed 5. What do I have? 4? It doesn't show, whatever. I think I had 3 or 4, I tell you. So there we go. We activate that silo. We can now enter this area freely using the silos. And, yeah, this area is a little rainy, a little down. But, yes, I believe in the next part, we'll be heading to Witchy World. That's the next area. And let's just learn this move while we're at it, you know. I don't want to waste too much time in the next part by doing this before then. For blasting things, these eggs were made. Don't stand close when they fire a grenade. Look at grenade eggs. Oh my god, this game's awesome. Love my grenade eggs. That'll be all. Dismissed. And, oh, he didn't fall. Okay. So, yeah, we learned a different egg style. Grenades. Yeah, these are actually pretty cool. Let's actually test it out on little Jimmy right here. Sorry, little Jimmy. Oh my god! I just incinerated him. Poor Jimmy. There's a Wumba in the tent right there. Wumba Hut. That's the only one that's placed in the overworld. But we'll see now what that does later on. And yes, I believe in the next part we'll be entering Witchy World. I believe it's called the funnest place on Earth, or the unfunnest place on Earth. Either way, we're gonna have a fun time, right? So, I will see you later, guys. Until next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie, we'll be entering the third world in the game, Witchy World. So, I will see you later, guys, and until next time.